my mouth, hoping that there'll be some surgery. Because the whoever is given the order has not contacted the surgeon per se, surgeon has not seen the patient per se. Next day, 11 o'clock, surgeon goes to see and he's got non-surgical issues, still nil by mouth. But there's no way we really work on it, and this nil by mouth is a very common thing. Quite often I say, I'll show you patients who have not eaten food for 3 months, nothing, one day you don't eat, nothing will happen. And that's how we try to justify ourselves. But this one thing we always say, I think we should be moving from that. All of us work hard together to make sure that to attain this, what is called a restitutio ad integrum, which means that we do everything possible to make a patient functional and bring back to his own whatever healthy state he was. Yesterday I was in Kolkata and I was giving an interview to some magazine and he asked, sir, how was that all patients move towards Chennai? What is that you people do other than what we do here? I said, we do the same surgery, what is done anywhere, but there are so many other things to it. We have radiologists who are excellent, our imaging is so fine, we discuss with them again and again. If needed, we do repeated investigations. Then we have excellent anesthesia intensivists, we have very good infectious disease specialists, and we have very good nutrition protocol. And our choice of antibiotics is excellent. And you know, the credit goes to all of these, frankly. And each one of us work on those lines, and that's how it matters. So that's the importance of nutrition. Dr. Krishnan Sriram was mentioning this. Even today, I'm sure every single surgeon operating on every single abdomen, the junior resident, all surgeon goes in the morning. First question he asks is this, have you passed gas? Patient will be in a morose or, you know, semi-sleeping situation. He will not understand what it means actually. For that matter, many a times, how will he ever know? He never noticed that he had a thing like that. Then the next senior goes, then the chief himself comes, asks the same question. This is an age-old custom, and what I would rather imagine is that after the end of the lecture, this question we are not going to ask again in our life. Now this auscultation, now you'll see, patient had surgery yesterday, then you know, four quarters.